Hi folks, this is Darren with My RV Works. Today we are in Port Angeles working on this Precision Temp water heater. Now this one is a Precision Temp, where is its part number? RV550EC. Now the customer states that it's not working. So let me bring you a little bit closer. We'll follow the trail and see if we can't figure out what's wrong with this thing. Okay, so let's start with a basic overview with theory of operation. So we see down here that the light is blinking. Okay, here, I've got a flashlight on. Let me cover that. So down there, you see that the light's blinking. That would be an indication that the system is enabled, that it's ready to go, and it's waiting for it to detect hot water flowing through the line. So when the water turns on behind this area here, you have a flow meter, okay? Coming out of the flow meter would be the yellow, black, and red wires that are going to go into the board. As a flow meter is flowing and detecting, you're going to see this light blinking. And there's a ratio, I don't have it in my head, but there's a sheet you could look at to determine how many gallons per minute is flowing through this. So that basically tells the electronics board here to fire in the hole, ready to go. Okay. Now the green and black wire down here with a fuse in it is where power comes into the circuit to begin with. Okay, so now we have detected flow. The board detects that there's flow, and what it's going to do is, let me get something to point with. How about instead of my hand, screwdriver? Okay, so here we have a brown wire. Let me pull it out here. Okay, so we have this brown wire. This brown wire. Here we go. My brown wire's back here. So this brown wire is going to leave the electronics control board. So the board got a signal to say, hey, let's go. Let's get some water going here. So it's going to leave this brown wire. It's going to do two things. It's going to turn on the fan in the back. You'll hear the fan start. And then here's our brown wire again, right here. This is like a proof switch. If this was a furnace, we would call this a sale switch. But this is going to read vacuum in the line, this red hoses for vacuum. So when the fan starts and we prove that there's a fan starting, then we're going to come in here to our DSI board, direct spark ignition board. Okay, so let me pull this harness out and show you that. Here, let me pull the electrode out and then I'll get to the harness. Okay, so here we have, can everybody see that? Yep. So power is going to feed my DSI board. In order for me to get 12 volts on this brown wire, I will have had to have detected flow on my flow meter. I will have had to have started my fan and then proven that my fan has started because of my vacuum pressure diaphragm. So that's how I get 12 volts to here. That's the trail. I come into this board, green is going to be ground, and when I come into this DSI board right here, there's two things that are going to happen. I'm going to send power out on my blue wire, and when I send power out on my blue wire, I will go then through my high temperature thermostat here. If I get too hot, I'm going to open, and then I'm going to go into the back here where my gas valve is. The other thing I'm going to do is try to strike an arc on my igniter right here. So that's the follow the trail thing. So let me plug everything back in and see where our power goes. We're gonna follow the trail. So there's just a real quick brief overview. Okay, that's plugged back in. That's plugged back in. Now what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get my meter set up and we're going to check the voltage on all these points that I just referenced and see if we can't figure out where the circuit is open or grounded or broken wire or something like that. So let's do that. Okay, great. I've got my meter started. First, what I want to do is verify I've got power. So one side of my meter, we're going to use a meter so we can actually see the voltage and see the current, mostly voltage, in the circuit. With my eyeball, I can't see this, but the meter can if I'm probing. So the meter always, it's like in basketball, you always have to have 1 foot planted or else you'll be traveling. So one side of my meter has to be referenced to something, and in this situation, I'm going to reference it to ground. So here over here, I use a little alligator clippy thing, and I'm grabbing the frame of the water heater. Okay, so this will be a test to see is the frame of the water heater grounded. Okay, and so hold on, I want everybody to see that. We're good, no glare. Okay, good. So I'm just going to touch this fuse right here, and I expect to see 12 volts. I got 13.3. So right now, 13.3. That tells me that my converter is working. I'm not here to work on the converter, but if I get something over 12 volts on my meter than it's coming through the converter. So we're good there. So I've got voltage. I see my light blinking right here. And so what I want to do is just come in the middle of my path. I'm going to just probe right into this brown wire right there. And because that's brown wire is coming out of this control board when we call for hot water. So I'm going to knock on the RV. Customer will then turn on the hot water source. Okay, and there's my voltage. We also hear the fan turning on. I did not get ignition though, okay? And I've got right at 13 volts. So we're there, okay? So now we're gonna come up here. We're going to see, we're following the trail. I've got 12 volts here. And so I've got 12 volts here. I've checked it on both sides. So now we're gonna come in on the brown wire and verify. Okay, so I've got 12 volts going into this DSI board, okay? But it's not igniting. Now there's one more thing I'd like to do, and that is make sure my ground is good going into that DSI board. So I'm referencing ground to the frame, but let's see if I can get this, because if there's no ground here, there we are, and get in there. So it was a problem of ground. Let me turn that off. What I want to do is get a better grab on that lead. That may be coming at it at a weird angle. Okay. There we go. Okay. Okay, so now I am in. Okay, there it is. I didn't have the pin in. So I'm getting 12 volts actually feeding the board. I'm referencing ground on the board. Now earlier, when I was referencing ground, I was referencing the frame. Here I actually wanted to reference the board itself because maybe there was something wrong with my green wire. So I can confirm at this point that this DSI board is in fact getting 12 volts. Now the DSI board has two jobs. I give it power. Well, it's more than that. And I expect voltage coming out on my blue. Let's check for that. Okay, so let me, I don't expect there to be power coming out on blue. I'm changing out my leads because it's, I know that the frame is good. Okay, so what we're gonna check this time is I wanna make sure I've got 12 volts coming out on brown, which I do, but I wanna see if I'm coming out on blue. I don't have spark ignition and I don't hear my gas valve opening and I do not smell gas. So let's go right into blue there. Okay, he should turn that on. Okay, nothing coming out on blue, but I do have it there. I have voltage on brown, but nothing coming out on blue. Nothing coming out on blue and certainly no ignition. So we've followed our trail. Let's turn the water off. Okay, so here's where we are with our trail. The first thing I would come to mind is my DSI board is bad. But before we say the DSI board is bad, let's check a couple things. If blue or black are grounded or shorted out, then this board won't ignite. We have a ground here, but we only want the ground coming in on the green wire. So at this point, what I want to do, I already pulled my meter out, but let's put the meter back. This time we're going to put the meter in continuity mode. There we go. And let's see, if I touch these together, I get a nice beep and I have no resistance. So again, I'm going to reference the same ground point. And there, if I touch ground, okay, so I've got a beep. So do I have a ground continuity between? Okay, so I've got 17 ohms of resistance. I'm going through a coil on the gas valve, so 17, that's why you never just go by the beep. You always look at the number. So 17 ohms, I might be going through a coil. Let's check it on this. I don't know, this is supposed to be floating in space. Okay, I've got a lot of resistance on that, 2000 something. So let me, what I'd like to do, I'm going to leave this guy unplugged, and I want to find out if my problem is on the gas valve side or is it on the igniter side. So I'm going to move my meter out of the way. I'm going to leave this off. And what I expect is if there's a problem with our electrode, then I expect the gas valve to open. And what I want to do is get ready to pull. So I want to get ready to pull this if something. Okay, so I'm just trying to be safe because I've got this disconnected. This is going to try to spark, and the gas valve should open as well. But if bad things happen, I've got my hand on the power to turn the thing off. So let's see what happens. Okay, I smell gas. And I actually heard an extra click. So we now know that our DSI board is good because I just smelled gas and therefore our blue wire is working. So now we've followed our trail. I think at this point where we are on our trail is either this part of the board is bad or this electrode's bad. So now let's look at the electrode. So how many of you would have just immediately replaced the DSI board because you're getting voltage in on brown but not on blue and not on this? So we need to take our troubleshooting a little bit farther and follow the trail a little bit more. So because I'm smelling gas, I'm going to say that the green board is sending the signal through the fan, through the switch, into the DSI board on the brown wire, and I'm getting voltage out on the blue wire, turning on the gas valve because I'm smelling gas, and I heard a ticky-tick sound. And so the ticky-tick sound might tell me this is good. So now let's isolate our problem to this thing right here. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this out, this whole electrode, and let me... Okay, so I would want to make sure that that's good, but let's actually go in and look at the electrode. Let me scooch everybody over a little bit. Hold on. All right, so... Okay. Now there needs to be a gap. We see that, can everybody see there? Yeah. Okay, so it's been working. There's some discoloration. That's fine, everything looked good. I'm also going to feel this prong. I wanna make sure that that is tight inside that ceramic housing. That's a little loose, but okay, well here's interesting. See how it's kind of curved in a little bit? I should have looked at the gap before I pulled this out. So what I want to do, let me get my flashlight and peek in there. Yeah, that looks wonderful. Okay. So I'm going to put this back in, but this time I want to really focus on the gap. I want to make sure the gap is good. Maybe the gap was wrong. If that electrode is touching ground, then we will short this out. I was getting a weird resistance reading. Okay, so I'm gonna put my screws in. Let's see, the other screws down there. Let's grab this guy. These are ceramic, so they're not magnetic, so that makes it a little less enjoyable to use magnetic tools. There we go. Okay. All right, so now I wanna look at the gap, now that that's seated. Okay, so that's actually touching a little bit. Let me pull him back just a little. Okay, what we're wanting there is about an eighth of an inch. So the trick there is to take an eighth of an inch Allen key. I painted it yellow. Yeah, it's still got some yellow on it. My paint pen. And let me slide this little jewel in here and get our eighth of an inch gap. Okay, we have an eighth of an inch. All right. It's an eighth to a 3/16. The gapping is a function of the diameter of the electrode. It's called flame rectification. So where did my right here go? Okay. And so let's connect this. I'm wondering if it was all this time, if it was the gap was touching something. All right, so I want to check my gap one more time. Now that I've been fingering it and everything. Okay, we are above it and we're at an eighth of an inch. Okay, so we're plugged in, so let's knock on the door. See if we get an ignition here. If not, then... Oh, hey, guys, look at that. Oh, how exciting is that? This is really wonderful. Okay, so it's working. Whoa, wow, got my glasses right in the heat. That does feel good. Let me move you guys back. Let's go. Okay, so that feels good. We have a flame in here. So we have hot water. So that's exciting. And here, let me get you guys a little closer because I can see my orange tip is glowing, which is what we want. So that tip glowing is a very good thing. And I wished I would have looked at the, if for some reason that electrode was touching first. Because when we followed our trail, at first I thought it was a DSI board. But let's just take a moment and see one more step farther. We unplugged this, verified we had it on blue, and we smelled gas and I heard it ticking. Plug this in. Before I took this apart, it would have been awesome if I would have seen it. It was touching. I didn't check my gap. I just took it apart. But yeah, I think we have a successful operation here. All right, folks, well, there you have it. I hope this was valuable to you, going over some of the highlights, theory of operation. If you understand theory of operation, you got a meter and some basic skills, I think that you can kind of follow the trail just like I did. So if this added value to you, give us a thumb up. We really appreciate that. Subscribe to our channel. You can follow us on Patreon. We're starting to build that channel even better over on Patreon for people who support us. We're sowing more into you. We've got some tools. I didn't use my test lead set on this one, but we've got some tools we're making as well. So, hey, this is Darren from My RV Works, where happy campers say My RV Works. So from Port Angeles, Washington, see you on the next video. Bye.